hour of one. It was just a dream then. Oh, are you the spirit whose coming was foretold?
I am.
Who and what are you?
I am the ghost of Christmas past.
Long past?
No, your past.
Oh, well, why do you come to me?
Your welfare.
Well, if it's my welfare you're thinking of, I can think of nothing better than an unbroken night's rest.
Be careful. I speak of your reclamation. Take heed. Rise and walk with me.
But good heavens, I was born here. I was a boy in this place.
Your lip is trembling. And what is that upon your cheek?
Oh, it's nothing, nothing. Lead on to me.
Do you remember the way?
Oh, remember it? Why, I could walk it blindfold. Oh, Dick! Dick Wilkins! It's me, Ebenezer!
These are but the shadows of the things that have been. They have no consciousness of us. They won't hear you.
Oh.
The school is not quite deserted. A young child sits alone. How many years were you there?
8 years.
That many. A solitary child, neglected by his friends, left there for the holidays for 8 long years.
Well, yes, but how can you say he was alone? Why, he had his books. He had dear old Alibaba, yes, and Robinson Crusoe, who sailed around the island, and Friday, who ran for his life to the creek. Whoop, hello there! Boy.
What is the matter?
Nothing, nothing. There was a young child at my office the other day singing a carol. I should like to have given her something, that's all.
Watch. There is more. Let us see another Christmas Eve.
Oh, my sister Fan.
Dear brother, I've come to bring you home, dear brother. To bring you home. Home.
Home, little Fan?
Yes. Home for good and all. Home forever and ever. Father's so much kinder than he used to be. That home's like heaven now. He spoke so gently to me one dear night. I was not afraid to ask him once more if you should come home. And he said, yes, you should. He sent me in a coach to bring you. We were to be a man and never to come back here. But first, we're to be together all Christmas long and have the merriest time in the world.
You were quite a woman, little Fan.
Always a delicate creature whom a breath might have withered. But she had a large heart.
Oh, that she did, Spirit. I cannot deny it. God forbid.
She died as a young woman and had, as I think, children.
No, one child.
True. Your nephew, who bears a strong resemblance to your sister.
Oh, does he? I never noticed.
You never noticed?
No.
I am beginning to think you have gone through your life with your eyes closed. Open them. Open them wide. Do you know this place?
Well, yes, I was apprenticed here. Oh, there's old Fezziwig. Fezziwig's alive again. Oh, bless him.
Yo-ho, boys. Hands down. Hands down, I say. It's Christmas Eve.
And Dick Wilkins. Dick and I were quite attached, we were. Oh, dear boy.
Everyone, let's make merry tonight. Now, hands are down. Let's get those shutters up quicker than we can say Jack Robinson, Ebenezer. Dickie, it's Christmas time. Quickly, quickly! We want to clear this place. Quickly! We are ready to make merry tonight. There will be dancing and fiddling. Plenty of time, Ebenezer, plenty of time. There's more to life than bolts of claw and musty old ledger first.
Yes, sir, I'll try.
Dear, there will be dancing tonight.
Yes.
Our fiddler has arrived.
She has. There's plenty of eat and drink. Let's eat, drink, and be merry to the break of dawn, I dare say.
Here.
Right. Oh, Belle! I'd forgotten how beautiful she was.
Shall we join the others, Ebenezer?
With pleasure, Belle. With pleasure.
Waste of time.
But you didn't think so then. Now did you?
Oh, humbug! that. It isn't that, Spirit. It's that he has the power to make us happy or unhappy, to make our service light or burdensome, a pleasure or a toil. Say that his power lies in words and looks, things so small and insignificant as to make them impossible to count. Well, what then? And yet the happiness that he brings is, well, it's as if it cost us a fortune.
What is the matter?
Nothing, nothing in particular.
Something, I think.
Oh, no, I'd just like to have a word or two with my clerk Cratchit, that's all.
Watch. There is more. Let us see another Christmas day.
Oh.
Do you remember?
Yes. Belle. Oh.
Hello, Belle. Sorry I'm late.
I thought you might not come. It matters little to you. Very little. I know how busy you are. Another idol has displaced me. And if it can cheer and comfort you, as I would have tried to, then I have no just cause to grieve.
What idol has displaced you?
A golden one.
The time of the year, the nature of my business, it's important to know I use my time and my talents wisely.
You fear the world too much. All your other hopes have merged into the hope of being beyond its sort of reproach. I have seen your nobler aspirations fall off, one by one, until the thought of money engrosses you.
What then? Even if I've grown so much wiser, what then? I'm not changed towards you, am I?
Our contract is an old one. It was made when we were both young and our prospects limited. Tell me, if this had not been between us, would you seek me out and try to win me now? A dowerless girl?
I was a boy. Have I shown otherwise?
Your own feelings tell you that you are not what you are. I am. That which promised happiness when we were one in heart is fraught with misery now that we are two. How often and how keenly I have thought of this, I will not say. It is enough that I have thought of it and can release you.
Have I ever sought release?
In words? No, never.
In what then?
In a changed nature, in an altered spirit, in another atmosphere of life, another hope at its great end, in everything that made my love of any worth or value in your sight. Ebenezer, I release you with a full heart for the him that you once were. May you be happy in the life you have chosen.
Wait, Belle, Belle!
Oh, Spirit, remove me from this place.
I told you, these are but the shadows of the things that could be. That they are what they are. Do not blame me.
No, Spirit, remove me. Spirit, haunt me no longer. Spirit!